Hey guys, welcome to Pentest Skills and welcome to the topic Routing of an Android Phone. So for routing an Android phone, you have to first get your bootloader unlocked. For that, you have to send your mail to the Redmi if your phone is the Redmi, or you have to find the other ways, whatever brand your mobile is. Once you have unlocked your bootloader, then you have to do two things. You have to download first TWRP installer and update SuperSU, right? Once you have downloaded, then you have to enable the developer option in your mobile. For enabling the developer option, you have to go to the settings as in this mobile is showing. So you have to go to first about phone, and then you have to click the version 6 to 7 times here. That you have to click, or whatever your phone, whatever brand your phone is. Once you have clicked 6 to 7 times, then you will be a developer. So once you have achieved the developer right, then go to more, and then go to the advanced setting, not more, additional setting, right? Then there will be a developer option coming here. Fine, go to the developer option, then do the certain configuration. As I say, go for OEM unlocking, enable this OEM unlocking, then enable the USB debugging. Fine, and after that you can also enable USB debugging security setting. You can enable that. Once you will enable it, then you have to connect your phone via USB with your computer. Once it is done, then you have to double click this folder, and you have to double click this TWRP installer.bat file. So once you will enable the bat file, so it will execute the fast boot mode, so that it will flash TWRP in the mobile. Before enabling or before clicking for TWRP, you have to go to your phone and use this volume and lower volume key and power setting to make your phone go into a fast boot mode. So after making your phone in the fast mode only, you have to double click the TWRP installer to flash the TWRP. And before that, you have to make sure that you have copied this SuperSU file in your USB. Fine. So once you have done that, and once you have successfully flashed your TWRP installer, then you have to go in the fast boot using volume key and upper key, and then you have to install that particular SuperSU using TWRP installer. So once you will install it, then SuperSU will get installed, and it will be like that. There you can see I have flashed your TWRP, and there it is SuperSU. So SuperSU will install the root access, and you can install this root checker for checking if you have successfully gained the root access of the mobile. So once you will click it, so the phone will say, or this app will say, that congratulations, root access is properly installed. So in that way, your phone will be rooted, and you will be able to get the admin right of the phone, and then you can further go ahead or proceed with the testing. In case if you don't want to root your phone, then obviously you can use the virtual machine software for mobile like Jenny Motion or Android Studio for pen testing of mobile applications. Jenny Motion is free for personal use, so definitely you can use it. It is much convenient and better instead of rooting your phone, or if you don't want to root your phone. Fine. So guys, that's all for this tutorial. Hope you have got the process of rooting your phone. There are plenty of material available on the internet which will help you in this process. This is the the roadmap of rooting a phone which I just explained. I believe that will help you in rooting a phone. Thanks for watching.